As of June 1st of 2025, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Hawaii's famed Kilauea volcano, which as of late has been producing once-in-a-generation levels of repeated episodic towering lava fountains. The last such episode of these occurred during the afternoon of May 25th for 6 hours, creating towering 350-meter or 1,150-foot-high lava fountains which were absolutely spectacular. While Kilauea as of today looks like this, that is only because it is undergoing a pause before its expected 24th episode between June 1st and June 6th. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Vanuatu, there seems to be fresh, notable ground deformation, possibly indicating the new rise of shallow magma at the Lopevi Volcano, which has not erupted since 2007. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, the Taal Volcano erupted once again, marking the first such eruptive activity in a little more than 3 months. And, while I have frequently highlighted in recent times the increasing unrest which was detected at various volcanoes, I want to now highlight a series of volcanoes that have recently had the exact opposite occur. For example, for a time it was considered highly likely, although not completely certain, that Alaska's Mount Spurr volcano would produce a subplanean explosive eruption in a time span of a few weeks to months, but that was all the way back in March. Clearly an eruption hasn't occurred, so what exactly changed? I could best explain the sudden transition from unlikely eruption to likely eruption back to a less likely chance of an eruption via the analogy of watching a basketball game as a spectator, where you are trying to predict at a specific moment if your favorite team will win. For example, if your team is suddenly up 10 points at the beginning of the fourth quarter, they in all likelihood should win and you can probably turn off the game and relax. Yet, due to a number of unexpected variables in a complex system, things changed, and you look at the score again 10 minutes later and see that they are now somehow behind. This is essentially what happened regarding Mount Spurr's geophysical data, which really did show that it was probably about to erupt in March, and then everything kept decreasing and is still decreasing today. So, while there was likely a 65% chance Mount Spurr would vaguely soon erupt in March 2025, as of the beginning of June, that number might only be 15% by the end of the year. Similar analysis is why Japan's Mount Ontake volcano, which had been at a raised alert level since this January, was lowered back to normal on May 1st. Hiroshima, also a volcano in Japan, had its alert level lowered from orange to yellow on May 27th. And the Lewatobi volcano, while still erupting, had its alert level lowered from red to orange due to declining activity on May 24th. In Vanuatu, the Lopevi volcano is located 134 kilometers north of the nation's capital of Port Vila. Lopevi is an unusually tall and steep volcano for its otherwise small size, with its central and acidic cone comprising the center of a northwest to southeast rift zone where flank eruptions can occur. This andesitic stratovolcano tends to erupt multiple times in clusters spanning a few years, only to be followed by 1 to 2 decades of no eruptions happening. We just so happen to be in one of the periods with no eruptions at the present, but with the theoretical potential for this fact to soon change. As, while unconfirmed, it seems that this northwestern vent has been uplifted by 25 centimeters or 9.8 inches during the last 2 weeks, suggesting the presence of rising magma. If confirmed, this would suggest a decent probability that it will soon erupt. Lopevi's historical eruptions have ranged from Strombolian to Volcanian to Plinian in nature, although most of its eruptions are Strombolian and create lava flows. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, the Taal volcano produced its first eruption in 102 days on May 29th, specifically at 9:21 p.m. local time. This event was a small phreatic eruption which lasted for 4 minutes, being completely confined to Taal's crater lake. The prior few days saw a drop in sulfur dioxide emissions and jump in earthquakes due to a likely small plug forming which then burst. And now, here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on May 31st of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.